Subscribe to my channel Your Tech Bro and hit the bell icon to get the instant notifications about the tech as soon as we upload.
Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Android smartphones are used in a large scale nowadays, and we people think that security for your Android smartphone is much more important than using it. Yes, and for the security reasons, we may put upon fingerprint, iris scanner, or passwords, or PIN, or patterns, etc., 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 many things. And let us think of a probability case that what if you forgot the password, or for the non-fingerprint devices I'm saying about, what if you forgot your password or PIN or pattern? Yes, you'll be in a panicked mode. And guys, this video will be helpful for those who forgot their passwords.
Hey guys, this is Dhanesh Shekhar and you're watching me on my YouTube channel, Your Tech Bro. And in this video, we'll be seeing how to unlock your forgotten password on your smartphone. Let's get in.
Okay guys, let's move on to the method number one. This method number one is very simple of all. And then as you can see, I have a lock in this device. I have put up a pattern lock. Yes, there is a lock. And then I forgot the lock. How could you unlock this device? That is gonna be the method number one. Okay, for this we'll be going to the recovery mode. As I'm using a Eureka device, the recovery mode to get into this device is pressing both volume keys and the home button, sorry, and the power key simultaneously. For Samsung devices, you have to press the volume down key, power button, and the home button simultaneously. And there are different ways to enter into the recovery mode for different devices. For Android users with the version above Lollipop 5.0, we'll have a pre-installed recovery modes like I have in the Samsung Galaxy S7 Edge. And for guys who are using Android version less than Lollipop, we'll have to manually install the custom recovery modes like that available in the markets, like CWM mode. As you can see, I have a CWM recovery mode, like Fills, like TWRP. There are many custom recovery modes, you can install it. Okay, the UI of this CWM recovery mode is like this, and the navigation keys are the up and down volume keys, and pressing the power button will select that menu. Okay, first we will go to the factory reset mode. We'll wipe everything. Okay, data wipe is complete. Then we'll go to the cache and then wipe the cache. Wipe cache is complete. And go to advanced and then wipe Dalvik cache. Dalvik cache is also wiped. Then reboot to recovery. After that process, your mobile will be redirected to the screen. Hit next. Hit skip. You can add your Wi-Fi at any time. Hit skip. Next. Next. And boom! You have unlocked your device without entering the password. And for lucky users who have synchronized their data, contacts, images, etc. with a Google account, Google will restore all the data within an hour. Let's head on to method number two. Yes, the method number 2 is grouped into two categories, that is Android version below 5.0 and Android versions above 5.0. Let's first see Android versions below 5.0 Lollipop. On my hand, I have a HTC device. Yes, this currently runs in Android 4.0. Let me turn on. This method is easy, and what you have to do is make some random wrong attempts. Make around 5 to 6. Okay, it says that you have incorrectly drawn the patterns. I have made it for 5 times. Please try again in 30 seconds. Okay, let me click OK. You will be having an option called Forget Pattern, and this option is only available in the Android versions below 5.0. It asks for your It asks for your Gmail account and the Gmail password. Okay, let me type in.
As you see, I have typed in the password. I'm clicking sign in, and my device is connected to a Wi-Fi network. It's checking, and it just goes to the unlock selection. Here you can just make a new password or just click none. I'm just clicking none here. Okay, let's see. Yeah, you have unlocked your device. Let's move on to a probability case that if suppose my internet connection or the Wi-Fi connection is turned off, what should I do? Just click this home key and then scroll down your navigation drawer. You'll find Wi-Fi option. I'm just clicking on this, and yeah, my Wi-Fi is connected and also my internet connection will be connected. In some devices, you doesn't get an option to scroll down your scroll bar in your lock screen home. In my case, this is possible. In some devices, this is not possible. Then what should you do? No props, don't panic. Just make your relatives to call you, and you'll be getting a calling screen. Just swipe right to enable the call, swipe left to disable the call. In that mode, you can just easily scroll down your navigation drawer and just click the Wi-Fi button or the internet connection. And in this video, we'll be seeing how to unlock your device with Android versions higher than 5.0. Yes, Google has improved a lot on its security updates over the past few updates of the Android. Above the Android versions above 5.0 will have to undergo this security updates called the Android Device Manager. Yes, in this method, we'll be seeing how to unlock your device using Android Device Manager. Let's turn into the Google and search for Android Device Manager. As I've done before, just click it. Just scroll down. You'll be getting Android Device Manager powered by Google. You have to click on that. And you'll be getting Google Maps some in such area. Just scroll down. This is the particular area where my device is being connected. And the connected device is Samsung Galaxy S7 Edge. Both are synchronous with the same Google account. Scrolling down shows that my battery percentage and the Wi-Fi network connections. And you'll be having an option to lock your device. And this is a recovery message, everything. Clicking on this will lock my Samsung S7H. You can do this whenever you want. You will be getting this option called Erase. Clicking on that, it says that all the data will be erased permanently. And that happens when you come online, not in offline mode. All the data will be erased in the device that is being connected. And one satisfactory thing is that if you use this method to erase your data or factory reset, you can restore your lost data from this device itself. That is a very good thing. And in this method, we'll be seeing how to bypass your locked device from a third party apps. That is, if you are using some of the third party apps from Play Store to lock your device, and how to get rid of that. Let's get in. First, switch on the device. You can see the third party app. I'm sliding to unlock. Let me go to settings and scroll down. We'll be finding the about device and hit the build number for 5 to 7 times to enable the developer options. And I have already enabled the developer options. You can see here, enable the toggle button of developer options. Just below, you'll be seeing an option called advanced reboot. Just toggle it and just get back. And long press your power button, you'll be getting this option. Hit the restart button. Go to soft reboot. This soft reboot is also known as the safe mode. And like in your PC, you'll be enabling a safe mode process. Similarly, Android devices also have some of the safe boot recovery modes. And enabling this, we'll go to the safe mode and let's see what happens. And now, as you can see, my device is restarted. You can see now. I'll just close it, and I'm entering, pressing this one. No other third-party apps can take part in a safe mode. Only the pre-installed apps will be present in the safe mode. Go to your settings. Go to apps. Yes, go to apps. You will be finding this option, lock screen. Here it is. Sorry. Lock screen. Engine. Uninstall this app. Boom. That's okay. Then turn off your device. Restart it to this normal mode, not the soft reboot mode. Click OK. Your device is restarting. That's it. You don't have any lock screen enabled.